What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Rooted Incorporated HQ.
Welcome. It's so cool we're standing today.
I know. And guess what, y'all? Did a phenomenal job last week
being rooted in Jesus.
And guess what? We had some of our friends show them being rooted in Jesus throughout the week.
What? I want to see it. Okay, let's check.
Here's how me and my brother spend a day with Jesus. Brush our teeth. We listen to worship on Alexa while we get ready. Let's do my skincare, and now we're finna pray.
Thank you for another day. We thank you for Zoe and Justin as they go to school and prepare to learn and have fun with their friends. In Jesus' name, amen.
And then we say our daily confession.
I'm strong, Peter, and not a follower. And do all things to Christ strengthens me.
Now we're finna go to school. Bye.
Oh my goodness, Biggs, you crushed it.
Incredible. I am just so proud of our friends. They did an incredible job.
I'm so proud. I love how y'all literally incorporated Jesus and were rooted in Jesus this week. If that's saying the creed before bed.
I know.
If that's listening to worship music in the morning.
Praying.
All of the things saying, that's so amazing. So I'm so excited for phase number two today. Which
phase number two is going to be so
fun. Yeah, wait, what are we doing for phase number two? What's happening? You know, you're kind of leading this one, so what are we doing?
Come with me.
Come with him. Where are we going?
Lex, are you coming? Oh, it's dark over here. Come on. All right, I need everybody in the room to stand up with me. Like, for real. Everybody stand up. Ethan, Noah, Judah. L, come on, let's stand up. Everybody stand up. Come on, here we go. All right, so we have four workouts today. And this is the first one. Everyone, we're gonna do the cactus pose. All right, yep, everybody, come on, here we go. 3, 2, 2, 1. All right, perfect. The next one, we're calling it the oak tree. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. All right, beautiful. On to the next one. We're calling it the bonsai. All right, everybody hold it. Still. I see you moving. Don't fall. Don't fall. Hold it. 3, 2, 1. All right, last one. And I call this one the palm tree. Here we go. Here we go. All right, hold it there. 3, 2, 1. All right, you guys did an amazing job. I'm gonna change real quick and I'll be right back. Woo! All right, so those exercises were crazy. Like, I'm still trying to like make it out of this thing. It was so weird. But in all seriousness, you guys know here at Rooted Incorporated, the most important thing is that we are rooted in Jesus. Come on, everybody in the room. Let's say rooted in Jesus on 3. 1, 2, 3. Rooted in Jesus. Yeah, being rooted in Jesus is the most important thing in our lives. And you may be saying, Taylor, what does that even mean? And this is what it means. So you remember the tree from last week? Well, if you weren't here, a tree has roots. And the roots are what keep it in the ground. It's what gives it nutrients. It's what allows it to grow. It's the same thing with us. Jesus is our roots. Like, when we are rooted in Jesus, we are able to grow into who he's called us to be. We are to be planted, so when life gets kind of crazy and we don't know what's going on, we're not gonna be tossed and blown in the wind, but we're rooted. And so a good example of being rooted in Jesus is going throughout our day. We can be listening to worship music. We can be praying. We can be asking God what he wants us to do throughout our day, who he wants us to talk to. If we have a test that's difficult, we can say, hey God, can you help me on this test? I'm kind of nervous. I studied and I know I'm prepared, but I'm really nervous going into this. Can you be with me? And he'll be right there with you. So the first one is, we are rooted in Jesus. So what we are talking about in today's training is so important. And it is that no matter what people say about me, I am rooted in what God says about me. And you know, I know we've all been there. We've all been there where someone has said something and it has really hurt our feelings. I want you to raise your hand. If that's ever been you and someone has said something and it's hurt your feelings, raise your hand. Cause me too. I've been right there. I've been right there when someone says something to you and you're like, oh man, that really hurt me. and I don't know what to do about it. And in those situations, there's one thing that you can do that will always help you. It is remembering what God says about you. What God says about you is the truth. What everybody else is gonna say, whatever, all of these negative things that can come at you, you can throw that to the side and say, you know what? I trust in what God says about me. And so right now, we actually have a story from our friend Lillian, and she's gonna talk just about that.
Hey, Biggs, Lillian here. I was going to share a story with you guys about how someday at school, some girls were saying some pretty rude things to me, did not feel good about it. Went home, cried a lot, told my mom all about it. She told me I could talk to Jesus anytime I wanted. That's been helpful ever since. I just want you guys to know you could talk to Jesus, your parents, or especially a Biggs member. They're always helpful to talk to. And I want you to know that God made you just the way you are. He doesn't want you to look like anybody else. If he wanted you to look like that other person, he would have made you like them. He wants you just like you. Well, bye, Biggs. Stay rooted in Jesus.
Wow, that was so inspirational, Lillian. And you know, when I was reading that, it really reminded me of a verse. And it's in Psalms 139:14, and it says, I praise you because you made me in an amazing and wonderful way. What you have done is wonderful. I know this very well. And that is so powerful, Biggs. Right there, what it is saying is that Jesus made you perfect. Like he made the way you are is exactly how he wanted you to be. So whether you're tall or short, or you're athletic, or you like playing video games, or you really, really love science, or you really love math, it's all on purpose. And I love at the end of the verse, it says, I know this very well. Like, guys, I want you to be confident. That's what it's saying. I know this very well. Like, you know for a fact that God made you just the way you are. And so, going to the third and final point of today's training, it is, what happens if someone does say something to you and you still don't know what to do? And so when this happens, what you can do is you can go and talk to someone. Guys, it is so important that when someone says something to us that's mean or that hurts our feelings, that we go to someone who will remind us of the truth. Someone who will take us right back to that verse that says that God made you in an amazing and wonderful way and that you know this very well. And so guys, as we go to the rest of this week, I want you guys to remember that no matter what anybody says about you, God made you in an amazing way, and you have to be confident in that. Love you guys so much. See you soon.
Man, what a good teaching, Taylor.
It was amazing. I mean,
that was awesome.
It's so important. No matter what people say about us, being rooted in what God says about us is the most important
thing. Number one.
So important.
We'll have so much more joy when we do that,
exactly.
Right? Okay, but now.
It's time for my favorite.
It's time for something crazy already. Drum roll. Challenge time! It's time for our challenge.
And
boys, you're going down this week.
We're doing really good.
Boys have one.
We're going to do so well this week.
Girls have zero. So girls, I'm going to need your support this week. Okay? All right. This game is not for the faint of heart. All right? Some of you have probably played this game before, and it involves water, okay? It involves water, so here you go. You get your little cup of water.
Are we doing a game where you drink faster? Like whoever drinks the fastest?
No, we're doing a game where you put water in your mouth,
oh,
and then we watch a funny video and see whoever laughs first is out. And we're gonna do two rounds, okay?
Oh boy, here we go.
Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
Okay. I'm gonna get the video out. Biggs, are you ready? Girls, are we gonna win this or what?
Boys, come on, make some noise. Boys, let's make some noise.
We got this in the bag.
Show them what's up.
We got this in the bag. Okay, let's put the video up. Are you ready? Oh yeah, let's get the water in our mouth.
Prank my dad.
Boys lost!
Hey! Bro, the way his dad threw
The way his dad threw it into you, just, yeah, that was
crazy. I'm sorry, boys.
All right, boys lost that round. Girls, we got 1 point. Ready for the next round? Let's get ready.
Okay, I got y'all this round. See you guys soon for something super special coming up after this.
Let's do it. What a day it's been Rooted Incorporated.
Yes, it's been amazing.
Amazing. How are you feeling after all those poses and workouts? You know, that was awesome.
You know, I'm a little sore, a little sweaty.
Is that you?
Yeah. Do I smell?
Yeah, you smell like palm trees.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'll take that as a compliment.
Yeah. Well, you worked really hard today. Biggs, you worked really hard
today. So hard.
And it's time for our last section of Rooted Incorporated, week number 2. Do y'all know what time it is?
I think we need a drum roll, please.
We do need a drum roll. On 3, 1, 2, 3, drum roll! It's
quiz time!
That's right. I have the clipboard in my hands here, which is the questions that I have. So yes. Look at the answer.
Sorry.
Okay, yeah, no cheating team.
I'm not gonna.
No cheat. Cheating team.
I got these answers today.
Oh,
I got
yeah, you do. You got them locked
in. Yeah, I got them locked in.
Okay, Biggs, you know the drill. We're gonna start with our first and second graders, okay? So, first and second graders in the room, raise your hand. We wanna see you. Acknowledge yourself, okay? We love you so much. Okay, we're about to put the question on the screen and some answers, and we wanna know if you know which one's the right answer. Are you ready?
I think they're ready.
Okay.
I think they got it. They
Let's
got
it. Do it. I'm gonna just read the first question. First question is just for the first and second graders. Finish the sentence. No matter what people say, I am rooted in blank. Number one, what my best friend says about me. Number two, what my parents say about me. Number three, what God says about me. Or number four, all of the above. Okay, Biggs, do you have your answer, first and second graders? Is it 1, 2, 3, or 4? All right, here's the answer. It's answer number 3. Great
awesome.
Job.
Yep.
The right answer is what God says about you.
Yep.
That's what we want to be rooted in, just like T taught us today. It was so good. All right, question number 2 is for our who in the room? Who's next? We had our first and second graders. Who's next? Do y'all know? It's our third and fourth graders.
Third and fourth. Oh, man, that's a big group of people. Oh, yeah. Y'all got this. Y'all are going to crush
y'all
this.
Y'all got this. Oh, okay, yeah. We're about to put the question on the screen. Question is, what does God say about you?
Oh, that's a good question. Good, you gotta know this. We have to know what he says.
We have to know it. Number one, I am made in God's image. Number two, I am loved. Number three, I am good enough. And number four, all of the above. Y'all know this one, Biggs? Y'all know this one, third and fourth grade? I know that y'all know it. Okay.
I have a little hint.
What's the hint?
I have a little hint. If you know your creed.
Oh,
if you know your creed. Say it every week. It's a snapshot of what God believes about us.
I think
that'll help you with this.
It'll help us. All right, it's answer number 4. Exactly.
Great job.
Great job, third and fourth graders. Now we're on to another page for our fifth grade
the fifth graders.
This one, I'm not going to lie, fifth grade, I'm not, no joke, this one's kind of hard.
This
one's kind of tricky.
I saw earlier, she asked me, and I I really, really, really had to think about it.
You did. Yeah. It's kind of tricky. Okay, are y'all ready? Are y'all leaned in, fifth graders? Okay, the question on the screen is, what happens when you're rooted in what God says about you? Basically, what can we guarantee that will happen if you're rooted in what God says about you? Number one, you will have more friends. Number two, you will have more joy. Number three, you will get better at your sport. Or number four, all of the above. What do y'all think it is? What happens when you're rooted in what God says about you? What for sure will happen? All right, we're about to give you the answer. It is answer number two.
Yep, great job.
That's
great
exactly
job.
What it is. So you might think, oh, if I'm rooted in what God says about me, I'll definitely make more friends. I'll definitely get better at football or dance. But really, that's not what God guarantees. He does want us to be better and he does want us to have more friends.
Yeah.
But what we can guarantee, and this is better than anything, is that you will have more joy if you are rooted in what God says about you. It won't matter if you are better at a sport, and it won't matter if you have friends or not, because you're gonna have God's joy. You won't even care. You're just gonna love who you are because who God made you is amazing.
Yeah.
So that's the end of our quiz time.
Yes.
We love you so much, Bitch.
So much fun. It was amazing. Y'all killed it today.
This was probably the best day ever. Yes. Not gonna lie.
Of course.
We'll see you at Rooted Incorporated week number 3 next time. Love you, Biggs.
Love you guys.